Hey everybody, we made it. It was a grind. It took 24 hours or roughly from when I started the day. I started getting ready to teach yesterday at 3:30. I got in the hotel 3 o'clock my time, which is 1 o'clock central time. Anyways, we got to bed roughly 3:30 by the time I got to bed. So it was literally a 24 hour day, but we made it. We got a free meal out of the deal. Thank you, Air Canada. All is well. We got here safely and had a good night's sleep. So I want to get into a few things here besides my five tips. The first thing that I'll mention is an interesting thing that I saw last week is I was on one of those new trial workshop classes or whatever workshops that they were putting on. And there were 270 teachers on that call. And guess how many guys? A whopping six guys. So that works out to roughly 2% of the teachers were male teachers on there. And again, that stresses my point of it is easier for me to become full-time because that's a way to differentiate myself, which is just being lucky, basically. So I'll just stress that again, that when I mention some of my numbers and whatnot, it is easier for me because I am a male teacher and there aren't very many. So that leads into my second point, which is on my bookings for last week. I had a great week. I really grinded her out because I knew I was going to be on vacation and I want to get as many classes as I could. And I think I'm at my quota. So last week I hit 75 classes that work out to, you know, roughly 300 a month if I could keep that up. I don't know if I could keep that going very long. And how do I know that? Because I fell down the stairs. So I didn't hurt myself, thankfully. But that tells me that I'm probably at my quota because I'm getting a little bit clumsy, my days are a little bit longer, and I probably can't keep that going for very long. I think my sweet spot is probably just in that 60 to 65 a week. I think that's where I could probably go and keep that going if I'm lucky enough, I guess, to get the bookings would be the first thing. But that's where I think my sweet spot would be, 60 to 65 bookings. But last week was a good week anyways. So let me go into my five different tips that I've got for today. And I'm sharing a lot of information that I've got from other people. And that's probably one of the other tips that I'll give that isn't part of the five. But watch as many YouTube videos as you can. I'm telling you, this has helped me big time become a better teacher. Not only that, attend every workshop that you can possibly get to. Go to every one. And I know if you're doing this part-time, you don't have a ton of time in your day to do it, but maybe you do one a week. Maybe you do, I don't know, a couple a week, whatever you can do in your schedule. But get to every workshop you can. Take notes as well and have them, refer back to them, because that is a way to become a better teacher. So watch lots of YouTube videos. Go to all the workshops that you can possibly get to because it'll help you become a better teacher. So that's outside of my tips. But let me get into my first one. Stand up in class. I'm telling you, I feel so passionate about this one. And again, I'm not trying to offend the people that don't, but I'm just telling you from my own experience, I am such a better teacher standing up. I've got more energy, and especially for those days where you're just like, oh, another class. Like, I don't know if I can keep doing this. Standing up helps to compensate for that a little bit because you're able to show that energy. The parents appreciate it. What I've done is I've got a yoga mat now that I put underneath my feet. It's about yay thick, and that helps me because my back was killing me at the end of doing, I would typically do 8 classes in a row in the morning, and this, my back would just kill, and that's a way to help. So if you can get a yoga mat, have that under your feet. Even better is if you can wear the padded shoes while you're at it with thick insoles, that would help. That's double good. But for me, I just use the yoga mat and that's enough to, my back doesn't hurt anymore. So that's the first thing that I'll get into. Stand up in class. It'll help you differentiate yourself and it'll help give energy to the classroom. Number two, and I don't want to beat this dead horse, but your rewards need to be good. I'm telling you, your rewards need to be good. It needs to be something where the kids be like, wow, that was fun. I want to go back. Because otherwise, if, you know, mom asked little Johnny, you know, did you like that class with teacher Andrew? And if you're just scooping ice cream, he's going to say, mom, in Mandarin, basically the translation, mom, that he just wasn't any fun. Like, he's a dud. He just scooped ice cream, mom. Like, don't send me back to him, please. So I'm telling you, that's, if your rewards are good, it'll just help you retain the student. You need to do a good job teaching, of course, but what I'm saying is that sometimes, even if you do a great job teaching, you're not going to get them back because your rewards were terrible. That's the honest truth. It needs to be, you need to find that balance of entertainment and education. You need to work that. You need to be as educational as possible, but we can do that by playing games at the same time. So I'll leave that at that point for that. Number three, encourage the living bejeepers out of those kids. We know factually that a stress-free environment or keeping that stress level low in the classroom helps them learn. And by you encouraging them, it is helping bring their stress level down and helping them learn and do a better job. So encourage, encourage, encourage. And your face says it all. So often the parents will say facial expressions on as a compliment to you. Your face gives it away on whether you mean it or whether you're just doing it because you're told that it helps. So keep that in mind. Look at your playback and look at your face. You need to be really into it and really encouraged to be authentic. You need to be authentic in your encouragement. So I'll leave that at that point. Number four, give good feedback. I know there are templates out there, the little templates that you can just customize with little Johnny's name in there, but I'm telling you, if you want to get as many bookings as possible, you cannot do that. You need to differentiate yourself in good feedback. And if you look back, I think it was a couple videos ago, I cut and paste exactly what I'm doing. Yes, I've got a template, but it's my own template, and I customize that big time to send off to the parents. And as I mentioned, I can kick one of these out in between classes, so it's not like I'm spending a ton of time either doing it. I'm able to do a good job, and I'm able to differentiate myself. And that leads me into my final point, number five, differentiate, differentiate, differentiate. Everything you do now, from now on, has got to be from the lens of how do I differentiate myself when I do this? And again, I don't want you to differentiate yourself and be less or not perform as well. It needs to be, how can I differentiate myself and be just as good or better by doing that? So what I mean by that is the feedback. If you differentiate and do a better job, it'll help. Another thing, another example, I guess, on the other side of just differentiating yourself and being equal to or whatnot. VIP Kids says, throw a photo up there that has a light background. I throw one up there that's got a dark background because that will help you stick out. Everything needs to come from that lens of how do I differentiate myself? Even little things like that. There are lots of other things. Some people, what they'll do is they say, hey, don't even get a professional photo. Go get a picture of you at Disney World with Mickey or whatever or something like that. And yeah, it probably works because parents are scrolling through all these teachers. There's 100,000 teachers. Remember that. And they're not going to click on the ones that just look all the same. Like, how do you pick out someone different that looks all the same? You need to differentiate yourself in something as basic as that. I like the professional photo because that's a little bit more my personality, but I've got a dark background. Anyways, I'll leave it at that. Differentiate yourself. Last thing I'll say, a little teaser. So I am in Houston, like I mentioned. It's not my final destination of where I'm going to in Texas. I'm going to another spot in Texas. If you know who I am and know what I like, you may be able to figure out what I'm up to. But I will tease that a little bit. Subscribe to my channel. Like my videos if you do like them. Come back. I'll do another video here on Sunday and give you a little bit more of what I'm up to. Anyways, I'll leave it at that. All the best in your teaching. It's the weekend. You got to love that. Take care, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye.